Hi, welcome to the second class of graph theory. These are some notations in graph theory. Delta is denoted as minimum degree and nu is equal to number of vertices and epsilon is number of edges. And what is alpha dash of g? Alpha dash of g is a number of edges in a maximum matching of g. And beta dash of g is the number of edges in a minimum edge covering of g. Then you must know about what you mean by an edge cover. Okay. Edge cover means that is a set of edges. Then edge cover means that is a set of edges. This is a set of edges such that every vertex of graph is incident to at least one edge of that set. Okay. Consider this graph. Right? Consider this edges, this set of edges. Then, can you say that this set will form an edge cover of this graph G? This is the graph G. Okay? Consider this is V1, V2, V3, then V4, V5 and V6. Take any edge, any vertices, V1. V1 is incident. Incident to which edge? E1. Okay. Take V5. V5 is incident to the vertex E3. Okay. And E2, V3. V3 is incident with the edges E2. Okay. So, this form an edge cover actually. This form an edge cover. Okay. And next is, so in this edge covering, the number of edges in a minimum edge covering of G is notated as beta dash and number of edges in a maximum matching of G is notated as alpha dash. In the first class, we have discussed that number of vertices in a maximum matching is notated by alpha and number of vertices in a minimum edge covering is notated by beta. Okay, so edge independence number is actually alpha dash, vertex independence number is alpha, edge covering number is beta dash, vertex covering number is beta. Okay, and also what do you mean by a matching? Matching is a set of edges without common vertices. This is actually a matching. Okay, this has no common vertices. Take E1, E2, E3. In the set, this E1. E1 is connected to V1 to V4. E2 connected to E2 to E3. E3 connected to V5 and V6. Okay. So, here there is no common vertices. So, this set is again a matching. Okay. This is a matching order. And the matching and the edge coverings are not related to one another. And the complement of a matching need not be an edge covering and vice versa. Next is, we have a definition. What do you mean by an M saturated vertex? Suppose M is a matching. Okay, a vertex V in V is said to be M saturated means if V is incident on an edge in M. Otherwise, we say that V is M unsaturated. So, for example, this is a graph G. This is M, E1, E2, E3. This is a matching. Here, take V5. V5 is incident with the edge E3. Okay, so we can see that this V5 is an M saturated vertex. V6 is incident with E3. So again, V6 is an M saturated vertex. Similarly, V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6 are M saturated vertex. Look at V7. Okay, what happened to V7? The edge is not, this is E4. Okay. The edge is not included in M. right? Then we say that this V7 is an M unsaturated vertex. V7 is an M unsaturated vertex. Okay, next we have a theorem, that is theorem 7.2. If delta greater than 0, then alpha dash plus beta dash is equal to nu. What is delta? Delta is a minimum degree and nu is a number of vertices. What was alpha dash? Alpha dash is a edge, number of edges in the maximum matching of G. Beta dash is the number of edges in a minimum edge covering of G. Let M be maximum matching in G, U be set of M unsaturated vertices. Given that delta greater than 0, also M is a maximum. Okay, then we have there exists a set E dash of mod U edges. U is a set of M unsaturated vertices. These unsaturated vertices is connected to at least U number of cardinality of U. Okay, that number of cardinality of U number of edges. At least that. Okay, so take that at least number, that is mod U edges, incident with each vertex in U. Then M union E dash, right? M is the maximum matching in G. Okay, M il illyatha vertices, okay, evide undavum? M ayittu connection illyathadana nammude U ennu parayna set. Okay, ini U ayittu connect cheythu edges um M ile edges um thammile oru relation um undavilla. Right, adu thammile adu M ile orikkalum U ilulla edges endayi kaniyalum M ile undavilla. കാരണം എം ഇസ് എ മാക്സിമം മാച്ചിങ് ആണ്, യു എന്ന് പറയുന്ന എം അൺസാച്ചുറേറ്റഡ് വേർട്ടിസസ് ആണ്. അപ്പോൾ ഈ അൺസാച്ചുറേറ്റഡ് വേർട്ടിസസ് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഈ വെർട്ടെക്സ് എടുത്തു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ അതിൻ്റെ എഡ്ജ് സെറ്റ് എവിടെ ഉണ്ടാവില്ല, നമ്മുടെ എമ്മിൽ എക്സിസ്റ്റ് ചെയ്യില്ല. ഓക്കെ, അപ്പൊ അല്ലാത്ത എഡ്ജസിന്റെ കളക്ഷൻ ആയിരിക്കും ഇവിടെ ഉണ്ടാവുക. ഓക്കെ, അപ്പൊ ഇവിടെ നിന്ന് ഒരു സെറ്റ് എടുക്കുന്നു, ഇ ഡാഷ് എടുക്കുന്നു. ഇ ഡാഷ് എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഈ ത്രീ നമ്പർ ഓഫ് എഡ്ജസ് നമ്മൾക്ക് എടുക്കുക. റൈറ്റ്, അതായിരിക്കും മിനിമം. എന്ത് കഴിഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാലും എത്രയും ടു വേർട്ടിക്സ്, വൺ വേർട്ടെക്സ് ഉണ്ടെങ്കിൽ എന്തായാലും വൺ വേർട്ടെക്സ് ആയിട്ട് കണക്ട് ചെയ്ത് ഒരു വൺ എഡ്ജ് അവിടെ എക്സിസ്റ്റ് ചെയ്യും. ടു വേർട്ടെക്സ് ആണെങ്കിൽ എക്സിസ്റ്റ് ടു എഡ്ജസ്. റൈറ്റ്, സോ യു നമ്പർ ഓഫ് വേർട്ടെക്സ് ഈസ് ദർ, സോ മോഡ് യു എഡ്ജസ് വി ക്യാൻ ചൂസ് ആൻ ഇ ഡാഷ് സച്ച് ദാറ്റ് E dash of mod U edges incident with each vertex in U. Consider M union E dash. We can easily say that this is an edge covering of G. Because M contains an edges. Okay. Adu kaiyittulla edges ellam evide undu? Nammude E dash il undu. So M union E dash is an edge covering of G. We have what was B dash? Beta dash. Number of edges in a minimum edge covering of G. Minimum edge covering number of edges beta dash. Okay, M union E dash is an edge covering. Since beta dash is a minimum, so beta dash is less than or equal to modulus of M union E dash. That is number of edges in M union E dash. That's equal to number of edges in M plus number of edges in E dash. Number of edges in M is equal to, that is alpha dash. That is alpha dash. So if M contains alpha dash edges, this alpha dash edges are connected to two alpha dash vertices. That vertices are not included in U. Okay, so the remaining vertices is equal to, actually that's equal to nu minus 2 alpha dash, right? Mod E dash is equal to actually nu minus 2 alpha dash. Okay, so beta dash is less than or equal to m modulus of m union e dash, which is equal to alpha dash plus nu minus 2 alpha dash, which is equal to nu minus alpha dash. Taking minus alpha dash to left side, so alpha dash plus beta dash less than or equal to nu. This is equation number 1. In order to prove the second condition, that is, let L be minimum edge covering of G. H is equal to the subgraph of G induced by L. Okay, H is a subgraph of G induced by L. Okay, L be the minimum edge covering. Right? Our edge covering include a subgraph on H. M be the maximum matching in H. Okay, H and the varena subgraph choose. U is a set of M unsaturated vertices in H. Okay, since M is a maximum, the number of elements in L, that is a minimum edge covering of G. Then what is L bar M? That is equal to, actually this is a number of elements in L minus number of elements in M. And we have this L bar M is actually, what is this L bar M? That is a, actually M is a maximum matching. Then L bar M contains, L bar M is a, in this set, that is a minimum edge covering, right? That is, okay, here L bar M is the means, M illa edges ellam oluvakittulladana L illundavu, that is the number of edges which does not contained in M. Okay, appo minimum ethra undu nammude kayile? That is, modulus of L bar M is always greater than or equal to mod U. So, this is equal to, what is mod U? Mod U is equal to, that is equal to nu minus. U contains actually how many numbers? That is, nerathe nammal varnu. Minus nu minus 2 alpha dash and the word. Okay. But M and the ethreano cardinality. M will suppose mod M number of edges and edges are connected 2 into mod M vertices. Ah, 2 into mod M vertices mod U and the word again, back in the area. Gamma nu minus 2 into mod M. Okay. So, this implies, this is actually mod L minus mod M, which is greater than or equal to nu minus 2 into mod M. So, nu is less than or equal to mod L plus mod M. Mod L is actually, there is a beta dash plus this is alpha dash. So, nu is less than or equal to alpha dash plus beta dash, which is equation number 1. Okay, equation number 2. Combining 1 and 2, we have the result. Combining 1 and 2, we have nu is equal to alpha dash plus beta. Next is, we have a definition, bipartite graph. That's a graph whose vertices can be divided into two disjoint and independent sets U and V, such that every edge connects a vertex in U to one in V. That is two sets in down U and V. Okay, that is disjoint and independent sets U and V, such that every vertex in U is connected to vertex in V. ഇതിൽ അങ്ങനെയാണ്, അതിനെ കംപ്ലീറ്റ് ബൈപാർട്ടൈറ്റ് ഗ്രാഫ് എന്ന് പറയുക. അപ്പൊ ഇതിലുള്ള വെർട്ടെക്സും ഇതിലുള്ള വെർട്ടെക്സും തമ്മിലാണ് കണക്ഷൻ ഉള്ളത്. ഓക്കെ, അതായത് അതിനെ പാർഷ്യലി ഡിവൈഡ് ചെയ്ത പോലെയാണ് ആക്ച്വലി അതിന് അപ്പുറത്തും ഇപ്പുറത്തും ആയിട്ട് നമുക്ക് നിർത്താൻ പറ്റും. ഓക്കെ, ബൈപാർട്ടൈറ്റ് ഗ്രാഫ്, റൈറ്റ്? സോ നെക്സ്റ്റ് വി ഹാവ് എ തിയറം. ഇൻ എ ബൈപാർട്ടൈറ്റ് ഗ്രാഫ് ജി വിത്ത് എ ഡെൽറ്റ ഗ്രേറ്റർ ദാൻ സീറോ, the number of vertices in a maximum independent set, number of vertices in a maximum independent set means alpha, is equal to number of edges in a minimum edge covering of in a minimum edge covering, that is beta dash. That is we have to prove. In order to prove this, let capital G be a bipartite graph, a bipartite graph, let G be a bipartite graph with the delta is greater than 0. Delta is the minimum degree which is greater than 0. How from the previous corollary 7.1 and theorem 7.2, theorem 7.2, we have alpha plus beta is equal to nu ആണ്, which is equal to alpha dash plus beta dash. From this we can see that alpha plus beta is equal to alpha dash plus beta dash. Okay, and we have a result in related to a bipartite graph, that in a bipartite graph the number of edges in a maximum matching is equal to the number of vertices in a minimum covering. Okay, that means alpha dash is a notation for number of edges in a maximum matching, and this is equal to alpha dash is equal to okay beta. When we are applying this to this condition, then we can easily say that there is alpha plus beta is equal to beta plus beta dash, which implies alpha equal to beta dash. This is our theorem. Hence, we proved our theorem. Okay, so section 7.1 is over. Okay, thank you.